Times in the Big Easy. Anthony Davis is expected to return to the lineup after resting during Saturday's win over the Lakers. The Philadelphia 76ers are in town tonight. Here's AD warming up as if to prove the point. A DNP and a 20-minute performance since the All-Star break for Davis amid all the controversy swirling about in New Orleans. I'll take on a Sixers team without Joel Embiid tonight, but with Tobias Harris, who has averaged 19 a game on 53% shooting in his six games in Sixer red, white, and blue. Hey everybody, it's Game Night. Hi, it's the Auto Trader pregame show here from our Atlanta studio. I'm Matt Weiner. We got Derek Fisher. We got the Friar, David Griffin, right over there.
Monsignor.
Good to have you with us. Sixers and Pelicans coming up tonight. Joel Embiid, as I mentioned, is out for the Sixers, which looked out of sorts Saturday against the Portland Trailblazers. Portland came in and dominated in Philly, winning each of the first three quarters to take an 18-point lead. They scored 41 in that third quarter. The Blazers out-rebounded the Sixers by 20, and Jusuf Nurkić went for 24 and 10 boards as the Sixers went mostly small after halftime. Something to watch tonight. Part of that advantage was on the offensive end, where the Blazers turned 19 rebounds into 19 second-chance points. A chance to bounce back tonight against the Pelicans. Earlier today, Jared Greenberg caught up with Tobias Harris.
All right, so I want to bring up Saturday, but not the game, the other game.
Yeah.
You checking out an outdoor hockey game, meeting the city of Philadelphia. What was that like for you, seeing those passionate sports fans in Philadelphia?
It was awesome. I mean, to see the energy that was at place there, and to see a different experience. I've never really been to a hockey game before, and especially one outside and in front of that many amount of fans, just showed the passion of the city and how much they love their sports team. So it was a great experience.
Listen, you're a New Yorker, though, right? And you're playing for the Sixers. You got to pretend like you're rooting for the Flyers, right? Is that a hard experience for you?
No, it wasn't too hard. I mean, as I said, I ain't been to too many hockey games, but that one was a new experience. And, you know, that I've been initiated. That's my new team now to follow. So it's cool.
Your friends on Long Island hearing that?
Yeah, that's all right. I don't care.
Let's get to what happened before that earlier in the day. And listen, obviously, it was a tough assignment for you guys to bring this collection of talent together in a short amount of time and figure out how to make it work. It's a good thing. We all know that. But without Joel, how much more difficult is that now to figure out the roles for everybody on the offensive end?
It's just an adjustment for us so far. So biggest thing that we can do is continue to have confidence in just the system that we have at hand and playing off each other. And I thought, you know, obviously this thing is going to take a little bit of time, but when it does, you know, marinate in the way that we want it to go in the direction, it's going to be really special. So without having Joel is a huge piece for us, but we need other guys to step up and just, you know, have some bigger roles there and be able to be confident into taking those roles. So it's going to be a big step for us, especially, you know, with the progression of the season and going into the playoffs.
For all the different teams you've played on and all the different roles you've been asked to play throughout your very short NBA career so far, do you have to, not only you, but everybody, do you have to look at the box score ever and say, all right, a guy like Jimmy Butler's got to get more shots, or I got to get more shots, just to make sure the offense is going in the right direction?
I think it's less on the box score and more on the type of pace that we're playing at and the flow that we're playing at. You know, we know when the ball moves, regardless of who gets the shots, we're going to get great looks, especially with the talent level on this team. So less about the box score, more about the flow of the game and how we're playing with one another and going out there and playing together.
All right, last thing for you. Tell me about tonight's game. Anthony Davis will play. How do you attack this Pelicans defense?
Just impose our will. I mean, we're going to have different matchups out there that we know we can exploit, and it's going at that, playing at a great pace and defensively being able to stop, you know, Anthony Davis, Drew Holiday, and their shooting guards. So that'd be our key today.
Appreciate the time before the game, Tobias.
No problem. Thank you.
There he is.
Thank you very much.
All right, we'll hear from Jared a little later on as well. So the Sixers are now 2-4 without Embiid in the lineup this season. Not surprisingly, the offense is worse, the defense is worse, and the rim protection is lacking in a big, big way. Is there any way to sort of quantify, other than those numbers, how big a void is left in that Philly attack?
Yeah, the numbers seem to tell us the whole story, and that's how valuable Joel Embiid is to this team. Most importantly, the defensive numbers jump out. You know, we love to talk about his offensive game and how versatile he is, but he prides himself on playing defense, and those numbers show it. One of the most important parts about defense is securing rebounds. And that's where the Sixers really got beat up by the Blazers, as you saw there.
Yep.
Nurkic just pushing Boban underneath the basket. Here with this smaller lineup, Enes Kanter, one of the best offensive rebounders in the game, just controlling and dominating the paint again. But then offensively, you see here, Kanter can just play center field with Embiid off the floor. Also allows Seth Curry not to have to worry about being in any help positions.
Right.
He can just concentrate on staying body tight to Redick. And so when you take Embiid off the floor defensively, the Sixers got beat up physically, 19 offensive boards for 19 points. But then offensively, the floor gets smaller.
Right.
And you saw J.J. Redick struggle to shoot the ball.
He was just 1 of 10 in that game on Saturday. And if you look over the course of the season, his net rating basically flip-flops when he's with or without Joel Embiid on the floor.
And since Tobias Harris has got there, he's been that way with Tobias Harris on the court, because the weak side defender is actually paying attention to Tobias now. So any of the movement and any of the running off of pin downs and those types of things that JJ would do utilizing a Joel screen doesn't exist, and the defense reacts completely differently. But to your point about the Sixers defense and the absence of Embiid, when they played their first game with Tobias Harris in that lineup, I think they got off to a 17-6 start in that game. And defensively, they were stifling. Joel was everywhere. And it's a little different thing. You can still be supersized with Boban on the court, but you're not nearly as rangy defensively. And that makes a big difference for that team.
Well, in the first half, they just kept putting Marjanovic in pick and rolls. That didn't work, and he basically didn't play in the second half, I think 3 minutes.
Well, when you go small, you basically chase him off the court.
Yeah.
And what's interesting is, to your point, Fish, when they went small and they kept Kanter on the court and went small around him, Kanter was able to do work in the paint, and there was nobody for Kanter to focus on guarding, which is a good thing because that's not his strong suit.
Correct.
So Portland got all of his strengths and didn't have to deal with any of his weaknesses that night.
Yeah. When you're missing Embiid, that's what happens. It allows for the opposing bigs to really just focus on providing help defense.
There's a look at Boban, the big fell. We'll see how much run he gets tonight against a bigger-looking Pelicans team with Davis in the lineup tonight. And they have some bigs who have been productive here lately, including Jahlil Okafor has gotten more run, and Shake Diallo.
What's interesting is Okafor, who high draft pick, I think he went number 3 in the draft, seemed to almost be forgotten and almost out of the league. And then here in New Orleans, he's found an opportunity to get minutes and show that he's capable of playing at this level. And it's a great lesson for so many people in our league, because everybody's time isn't right now.
Right.
But just remaining patient, working hard. Okafor's done a great job. Diallo's done a good, really good job. And to think about the center position with all of the controversy surrounding Anthony Davis, you got to give these guys a lot of credit. And Alvin Gentry for trusting, and obviously his staff, helping these guys develop on a daily basis.
And again, they've won 2 of 3 coming into this one against the Philadelphia 76ers. And if you're just with us, Anthony Davis is expected to play tonight. We'll see if he's around that 20-25 minute mark that we sort of anticipate. But what a play out tonight in New Orleans. Drew Holiday's minutes maybe coming down as well down the stretch, as the Pelicans are a team that likes to play transition ball and a franchise very much in transition.
You can't see Drew Holiday. You can't see Jimmy Butler in the background in that. He's wearing a purple suit, Jimmy Butler.